I'm Rachel Rocha.
And I'm Chuck Riepenhoff.
Today, we're going to talk to you about how to manage diabetes through healthy eating and exercise. Let's get started.
It's important to know that complications from uncontrolled diabetes can be prevented. There is action you can take to properly manage your diabetes.
That's right. From healthy eating and staying active, to taking your medications as prescribed, and monitoring your blood sugars on a routine basis, and even just simply staying connected with your healthcare providers are all tools you can use to keep your blood sugar at goal and under control.
We encourage all patients with diabetes to meet with a dietitian. It's important for you to know how many carbohydrates are in the foods that you eat. A dietitian can also help you understand how other types of food affect your blood sugar, such as protein, fiber, starches, and fat.
And once you learn about the different nutrients that make up the foods you eat, it's important for you to learn how much of those nutrients you should have in your daily diet. And it's important for you to know where to look for this information.
We encourage everyone to pay attention to the nutrition facts of the foods you eat. And there are some great apps and websites out there that you can use when eating out.
When looking at this information, keep in mind a common goal for total carbohydrates is to limit snacks to between 15 to 30 grams of carbs and 45 to 60 grams of carbs for meals. But of course, a dietitian can help create a meal plan that works for you.
Another tool to help manage diabetes is exercise. Exercise is good for all of us. It's beneficial for heart health, weight management, increases energy, lowers stress, and improves our sleep. And for patients with diabetes, exercise can be just as effective as any medication in lowering your blood sugar.
The goal for exercise with diabetes is 150 minutes per week, that no more than 2 days go by without some form of exercise, and that ideally your weekly exercise routine comes from a blend of both aerobic activity and some resistance with light weights or bands.
To make it simple, it's beneficial just to keep yourself moving. Take the stairs instead of the elevator. Park further away to help increase your steps. Do yard work, gardening, and projects around the house. And when watching TV, or if you have a job that involves mostly sitting, make it a point to get up every 30 minutes just to move and stretch around.
Of course, talk to your doctor before starting an exercise routine if you have any concerns about your limits. There are plenty of low-impact exercise options for patients with limited mobility. And there are some great apps and programs out there to help you track your progress.
To learn more about diabetes, be sure to check out the other videos in this educational series.